Dhyat Kamaha Swarajya Paribhavita Durlava Napi Siddhanam Mukundam Hiridi Pashataha Sambhadayanti Yat Kamaha Swarajya Paribhavita Pavita Dulava Napi Siddhanam Mukundam Hirti Pashyata Sambhadayanti Yat Karma Swarajya Paribhavita Dulava Napi Siddhanam Mukundam hirdi pashyata Samavadyanti yat karma Swarajya paribhavita Durlabhanapi siddhanam Mukundam hirdi pashyata Sambhadayanti yat karma Swarajya paribhavita Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukundam yidi pashyata Sambarayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavita Anam chetanam Sambadayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavitaha Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukundam hiti pasyata Sambadayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavita Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukundam hiti pasyata Sambarayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavita Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukanam hiti pasyata Sambadayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavita Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukundam hiti pasyata Sambadayanti yat karma Svaraja paribhavita Dulabhanapi siddhanam Mukandhi dipasyata Sambadayanti Increase happiness Yat Because Kama Such aspirations Svarajya, situated in his own constitutional position, of rendering service to the Lord. Paribhavitaha, saturated with such aspirations. Durlabha, very rarely obtained. Na, not. Api. Also, Siddhanam, of the great mystics, Mukundam, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hridi, within the core of the heart, Pashyata, persons always accustomed to seeing Him. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Abhay Charanaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Those who are saturated with the transcendental happiness of rendering service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead are uninterested even in the achievements of great mystics, for such achievements do not enhance the transcendental bliss felt by the devotee who always thinks of Krishna within the core of his heart. Please repeat. Those who are saturated with the transcendental happiness of rendering devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead are uninterested even in the achievements of great mystics. For such achievements do not enhance the transcendental bliss felt by a devotee who always thinks of Krishna within the core of his heart. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. A pure devotee is uninterested not only in elevation to the higher planetary systems, but even in the perfections of mystic yoga. Real perfection is devotional service. The happiness derived from merging into the impersonal Brahman and the happiness derived from the eight perfections of mystic yoga, anima, lagima, prapti, and so on, do not give any pleasure to the devotees. As stated by Srila Prabhupada Ananda Saraswati, Koivalam narakiyati tridasasha akash kushati durandendriya kala charpa patali proktata damsvayate vishvam puna shukhatyati piti mahendra discha kitayate yat karunaya katasha vaibhava vatam tat guram ivo stumaha. Chaitanya Chandramrita, number 5. When a devotee has achieved the position of rendering transcendental loving service to the Lord through the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, he thinks the impersonal Brahman to be no better than hell, and he regards material happiness in the heavenly planets to be like will-o'-the-wisp. As far as the perfections of mystic powers is concerned, a devotee compares it to a venomous snake with no teeth. A mystic yogi is especially concerned with controlling the senses. But because the senses of a devotee are engaged in the service of the Lord, Hirishikina Hirishikesh Shavanam Bhakti Ukjate, there is no need for separate control of the senses. For those who are materially engaged, control of the senses is required, but a devotee's senses are always engaged in the service of the Lord, which means that they're already controlled. Param drishtva nirartyate, Bhagavad Gita 2:59. A devotee's senses are not attracted by material enjoyment. And even though the material world is full of miseries, the devotee considers the material world to be also spiritual, because everything is engaged in the service of the Lord. The difference between the spiritual world and the material world is the mentality of service. Nirbanda Krishna Shambhande Jukta Vairagam Uchete. When there is no mentality of service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one's activities are material. Prapanchi Kataya Bhutya Hari Shambhandeni Vastunaha Mumukshu Bhi Parityago Vairagyam Palgukal Katyate Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1:2, 2:5, 6. That which is not engaged in the service of the Lord is material, and nothing thus engaged should be given up. In the construction of a high skyscraper and the construction of a temple, there may be the same enthusiasm, but the endeavors are different. For one is material and the other one is spiritual. Spiritual activities should not be confused with material activities and given up. Nothing connected with Hari, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is material. A devotee who considers all this is always situated in spiritual activities, and therefore he has no longer attraction, and therefore he is no longer attracted by material activities. param drishva vivartati. Omagyan timirandasya chakshuram nirtanjinata. Omagyan timirandasya jananjanan shalakiho chakshuram nirtanjinata shmai shri grima. Jaya Shri Krishna, Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Garata, Shiva, Shri Gaur Bhakta Vrinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Rama Ram, Hare Hare. So Prabhupada sang here in the purport. The difference between the spiritual world and the material world is the mentality of service. The difference between the spiritual world and the material world is the mentality of service. So, who is that who decides mentality of service? When you work, who makes the decision of the mentality behind the activity?
The boss.
Which boss? The big boss or little boss? So, Krishna said to Arjuna, kill your family members. Arjuna said, no, Krishna, I cannot kill my family members. It is sinful. Arjuna's mentality of service is right or wrong?
Wrong.
Krishna said, you're in Maya, Arjuna. Then Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita. Then he asked Arjuna, now what do you want to do? After you have spoken Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna said, I'm going to fight for you, Krishna. I'm going to kill for you, Krishna. Even my own family members. So what changed here? Same battlefield was there. Same chariot was there. The same Krishna, the same Arjuna. Half an hour ago, Arjuna was in Maya. Half an hour later, he wasn't in Maya. But what had changed? Consciousness, yes. His mentality of service changed. So this is what we are trying to do here. Krishna consciousness changed the mentality of pleasing the senses of Krishna. So, Srila Prabhupada said, your next body will be determined according to your mental condition at the time of death. That determines your next body. Mental condition, the subtle body, that will determine. Anta Narayana Smriti means at the time of death, one should be remembering Krishna. This is the purpose of all the rules and regulations. Always remember Krishna. And?
Never forget Krishna.
Never forget Krishna. Mm-hmm. So this is Mahaprabhu's mission. He has come to give.
Krishna prema.
Krishna prema. How do you get prema? You've got to chant the holy name. Service, yes. The service is the mercy. service, why? Jivha Srupaya Nitya Krishna. Das. Anudas. Yes, we are servant, or the servant, or the servant, or the servant. Chaitanya Charita says, Gauranga Nityananda, they've appeared on the horizon of West Bengal, eastern horizon, to bestow upon them the living beings the mellows of transcendental loving service to Krishna. The mellows of service. So this is why Mahaprabhu has come, to give seva. Adbhut Mandir, TOVP. Adbhut Mandir, Hoi Vipi Krash, Gauranga Nitya Seva. What do you mean? Gauranga Nitya Seva, Hoi Vipi Krash. By the desire of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, an astonishing temple will be here. And from that temple, Gauranga Nitya Seva, Hoi Vipi Krash. That will be expanded everywhere. Service to Gauranga. So Mahaprabhu has come with this mission of giving seva, service to the living entity. If you take the fish out of water, is he happy?
No.
What makes him happy?
It's not his environment.
Exactly. Yeah, the fish is out of his environment. You put him on the land, you can give him anything you want, but he's going to... Until he's dead. Only if you pick him up and put him in the water again. Because that's his constitution, yes, good word. The constitution. Jivaya Srupaya Nitya Krishna Das. That is our constitutional nature. So Mahaprabhu has come to give us service, devotional service. Who else is giving service? Huh? Devotees. If you're not born in ISKCON, if you're not fortunate to be a Gurukulian, then who actually gave us service in this material world when we were young?
Parents.
Parents. Your parents gave you Krishna consciousness? No. Your mother didn't give, your father didn't give. The politicians, they're the leaders. Did they give? They never ordered it. Everybody should come out in the street. Everybody, we can do a Harinam Samkirtan. Rather the opposite, right? What are you doing chanting on the street? Scientists. These are the real leaders. That's why they get so much money to spend on not devotional service. How to speed up, accelerate death. Already we're going to die, but they invent the means of how to accelerate that death. What is their credit? My teacher didn't tell me. What was the use of going to school or university? None of the teachers ever tell you. How many millions of newspapers are being published around the world every day? And how many times, if you ever pick up a newspaper, do you read that you are the servant of Krishna? Krishna is the Supreme Personality. And there's millions and millions and millions of newspapers since they invented the newspaper. Do some research work. How many times did there was one article, you are not the body, you are the soul, you are servant of Krishna. Then Prabhupada came. What did Prabhupada say? Yeah, I've got something for you. Service. Service to Krishna. You need service. That's what we need more than anything else in the world. But nobody is giving it except Prabhupada. Picked us out of that gutter of material existence. I've got a message from your father, Krishna. He loves you. He wants you to come back home. While you are rotting in this material world, come back home and do some seva. Do seva, then come back home. So this is Prabhupada's greatness, and of course Prabhupada introduced us to the other Vaishnavas and the Sampradaya and this whole spiritual realm of Golok. This is done when we meet devotees of the Lord, especially the pure devotees of the Lord, which is what we're talking about here. So Mahaprabhu has come to give his service. So why we emphasize service so much? What does Krishna need? What does Mahaprabhu need? He's the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He's, everything is his. Purnam, he's complete.
Our heart.
It's your heart, something inside the heart. he's come to emphasize service because it's through service that we can express our love for Krishna. How else can we express love without service? Service means there is a relationship. If there's no relationship, there's only one, how you can render service? So how can you express your love? So service becomes the medium to love Krishna, to serve Krishna, to show our love for Krishna. So that, what was it? Mentality of service. So this is the kindness of Mahaprabhu. And Krishna also. They come to give savorism, the main thing. So, yeah, because of service, then we have a means or a medium by which we can express our love for Krishna. So, Mahaprabhu comes and he has freely given his service. That is why he's Mahapadanaya. Namo Mahapadanaya, Krishna Prema Padayati, Krishna Krishna Chaitanya Namana Govinda Prasimha. So he's giving the medium to everyone and everyone. That's free. That's his greatness. He is giving free. How you render that service? What is your mentality of service behind? That is up to you. Here is the means by which you can express your love is service. But how you express it, that's up to you. That's up to every single person. That is your bhakti. You've got the means of service. That's giving freely. Now you've got to cultivate the attitude, the mentality of service. Bhava grahaya janardhan. Janardhan is accepting the mood of devotion, the feeling behind your service, not the service itself. But the Bhava Graha Janadan, Lord is in the heart, is known as Janadan. He accepts the mood behind the service. In this way, Krishna also protects the holy name, he protects devotional service, because you actually got to perform the devotion. You're getting the means to do it, you're getting the service. Now how you do it, you could do it offensively also, or you could do it with bhakti. Someone asked Prabhupada, how can, if a devotee is performing devotional service, how can he be in Maya? And Prabhupada said, the pujari, he's offering artik, and he's thinking of sex life. So service is going on, but mentality behind the service, not exactly Krishna conscious. So that's up to the living individual to express his love through Krishna, through that medium of seva. So here it's saying that the yogis, the jnanis, kamis, they will have some process. To attain their goals. The jnani, he has his process. He's very strict, keeps himself very pure, performs austerity, studies the Vedas, cultivates knowledge. The yogi, he undergoes very severe austerities. He controls the different hungers and limbs of the body and gets different siddhis. And the karmis have to work hard to get their result, money, then I can enjoy. So different activities, you expect a different result. But and when you get the result, then you give up your activity. When you get liberation, you give up the process of liberation. That's the jnani. The jnani wants to merge into the Lord. So he follows the path of jnana, but ultimately then he has to, when he gets it, his perfection, he gives it up. The yogi also, he performs so much austerity, but when he gets his siddhis or whatever, then he gives the process up. But for the devotee, the means and the end are the same. The process is devotional service, and the goal, you go back to Godhead. That is the goal. And what are you going to do there? You perform devotional service. So the means and the end are the same, whereas the other processes, you have to give up the process itself. But in the process of bhakti, it's not necessary to give it up. Of course, here we're performing Vedi Sadhana Bhakti. There is a slight change. We'll perform spontaneous devotion service when we go back to Godhead. But the idea of service, devotional service to the Lord, that doesn't change. Because it is the eternal nature of the soul. So that's on the absolute platform. Bhukti mukti siddhi kami sakali ashanta. Bhukti, liberation, mukti. Bhukti is enjoyment. For the kamis, they want enjoyment. Mukti, the jnanis, they want liberation. Siddhi, the yogis, they want siddhis. What is the result of this? Bhukti mukti siddhi kami? Chaitanya Charitamrita? Sakali Ashanta, not peaceful. Shanta means peace. Ashanta means not peaceful. They're following these different paths, but of Bhukti Mukti City, but they're all not peaceful until they ultimately get their goal. But the devotee, oh, he's Shanta, he's very peaceful because he's satisfied. He's got some service for Krishna. That's satisfying for him. Whereas all the others, all the other different processes, they're tainted with selfish desires. The bhakti, as we understand it, should be free from all material desires, any desire, except just pure devotional service. So, why are there so many different processes? Different mentalities, exactly. Well, what is the mentality?
Enjoying
and controlling. So this is the mentality, the Purusha Bhava that living entities have, the conditioned souls of this world. We have a Purusha Bhava, or the Purusha means the enjoyer, and his emotion is enjoying. So he is the controller and enjoyer. All living entities have this. What's everyone doing? They're running around. They're controlling a little situation so they can enjoy it. That's controlling and enjoying. Who is the controller and enjoyer? Where does it say that in Bhagavad Gita? Bhoktaram means the enjoyer. Bhoktaram jagratapasham. Sarva loka mahesh, all the planets. I'm the controller of all the planets. I'm the enjoyer of everything. Krishna says. But we're trying to imitate Krishna. We say clear imitation. We're a clear imitation. Everybody is trying to control the situation and enjoy it. Clear imitation of Krishna. But that's taking Krishna's ego, Krishna's identity. I'm the controller, I'm the enjoyer. So Krishna says, sarva dhanam parityaja mamikam. So you give up all those dharmas. Krishna spoke all those dharmas to Arjuna. All these different types of yoga. Knowledge of sannyas, yatma, super soul, vanashram, meditation. Ooh, so many different processes. Krishna spoke at the end of Bhagavad Gita, sarva dharma, give up all these dharmas and just surrender unto me. So why didn't he say this in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita? Why wait till the 18th chapter? Why not have just say at the beginning of Bhagavad Gita, bas, you finished. Bhagavad Gita, as it is, there's only two shlokas. Manmana bhava mad bhakto and sarvadhanam parityaja mamikam. We don't need any more. But Krishna did speak all this. And then he tells Arjuna to give them all up. Why? Because of this mentality. Different degrees, different persons, everyone has a different mentality. So someone will be the controller through as karma yogi, enjoying the material world, friendship, society and love. Someone wants to be a controller enjoying the bliss of Brahman. Someone wants to be in control enjoying the different cities. So because they have that mentality, I can do it like this, I'll do it like this, I can do it like this. Then Krishna speaks Bhagavad Gita for all those different processes for those people who are still attached to this idea of enjoying in this particular way. I'll do it my way. In the Navadipta Mahatmya, in the beginning. Nityananda Prabhu, it must be, or maybe Bhaktivinoda Thakur, says, oh, Mahaprabhu coming, he's giving here. Take, I'm giving love of God freely. You take it, just dance and chant in ecstasy, forget everything else. Some fortunate people took it, others they could not take. Then he says, I think Bhaktivinoda Thakur, let's examine why the others could not take. What was the reason they could not take? Huh? Selfish enjoyment. No piety. Pride, yes. Yeah, he says, the actual words he says is, they're overly proud of their own abilities to do things. Even love of God is being given freely by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I'll do it my way. So this is one that's overly proud of his own abilities. And in this way he's unfortunate because he misses the mercy. But he's thinking, I can do it my way. Whatever I do is the best way, so I'll do it my way. So therefore I'll do it through yoga, I'll do it through jnana, I'll do it for Krishna. So therefore Krishna says, okay, this is for you, this is for the karmic, this is the jnani, here is your destination, here is your process. But they're all nonsense, controlling and enjoying process. Every single one of them, you examine them. You examine. I examined one time in Hrishikesh, and if you Hrishikesh, especially in the really developed now, big buildings, nice places, and mostly all ashrams, all different types of. Everyone goes to Hrishikesh, it's a very fashionable place to go and have your guru there and have your process and things like that. But there's hundreds and hundreds of different types of yoga there and different types of ashrams, you know. Simple ones on the bank of the Ganga and like kind of luxurious ones. And they're all got different processes. Some are worshipping demigods, some are even doing bhajan. And not with the intention of really pleasing Krishna, but anyway, I was talking to a couple of people who were there. There's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. But the conclusion was that we're doing this process because we want happiness from it. Either spiritual happiness, spiritual bliss, or material peace of mind or something like that. But that was their goal. No question of seva. Forget that. Nobody wants to be a servant. That's gone. Only that's going to give me some kind of happiness. The goal was their happiness. And Krishna's out the picture. The service is out the picture. Just me and I want my happiness. So this is the bhavarog, the material disease. This identification as being the controllers and enjoyers of the of this material world. Dharma, Artha, Karma, Moksha, these are the progressions in life. The devotees don't even want those. They even kick away all those. They only want to love Krishna, that's all. So So Krishna's name, form, quality, pastimes, they're non-different from him. And Krishna's pleasure is also non-different from him. Krishna and Krishna's pleasure is non-different. So when the whole idea of bhakti is that we're doing everything for Krishna's pleasure. And the pleasure is non-different than Krishna. It's like the name in Krishna is absolute. So when we serve to bring Krishna pleasure, automatically we get pleasure. It's not a separate thing. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur gives an example. Krishna is calling the gopis. Full moon is up. So the gopis, they all run to Krishna. They decorate themselves very nicely, dress themselves, and go to see Krishna. He's calling on his flute. And the gopis say, now we dress ourselves very beautifully and we make our face look very beautiful and everything else. Because we know Krishna, he likes beautiful girls. He likes to associate with them. So let's make ourselves very beautiful. And they rush off to see Krishna. He's calling us to enjoy, and we want, we are for this purpose. So we dress nicely, we go to Krishna and please Krishna's desires. And we get pleasure from that also. But that's not the reason we went. We went for Krishna's pleasure. But because Krishna was pleased, automatically we got pleasure. So what is the harm? We didn't come for our pleasure. We came for Krishna's pleasure. By giving Krishna pleasure, then we get that pleasure. We are reflections of Krishna. Or you decorate yourself in front of a mirror. The more beautiful you become, the more beautiful the decoration also becomes. The reflection comes. So we are like reflections of Krishna. So the more we beautify Krishna, the more the reflections, we become beautified. Krishna and Krishna's service is absolute. And the mentality behind the service, performing the activity for Krishna's pleasure. So that's also absolute. So we are pleasure-seeking by nature, anandamaya bhaisha, that is natural. But here, Prabhupada said, this is the way to actually get that real pleasure that we are searching for. We want to satisfy Krishna. We are interested in Krishna's pleasure. Just like when we chant, when we do our japa, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur has given what constitutes nama seva. Nama seva. He gives three reasons. Three. What constitutes nama seva? Is that with the conviction and understanding that Krishna and his name are non-different. This before you chant. When you're chanting, you're just absorbed in the yoga. Before chanting. With the understanding, Krishna and Krishna's name are identical. They're non-different. So Krishna, he can reveal himself through this. The holy name will reveal himself. So the name of Krishna and Krishna are identical. You should be approaching the holy name in the mood of service to the holy name. And three, you should not be expecting anything back from the holy name when you're chanting. So this is not expecting anything back. This is like This is the mentality we shouldn't be. It's pointing out to the what was it? Mentality of service. This is the difference between the spiritual world and the material world is the mentality of service. So this not expecting anything back from Krishna. So generally we do things with the mentality to get something back. But it's not necessary that we aspire for this happiness from the holy name. We learn how to just chant to please the holy name in the mood of service, not expecting anything back from the holy name. Then the holy name is pleased, then you'll automatically feel pleased. Okay, there's 9 o'clock. Okay. So, the difference between the spiritual and the material world is the difference between the spiritual world and the material world is of mentality of service. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki jai. Nitai Gaura Premanandi.
Hare Krishna, I've been asked to make an announcement. On the 23rd of October, there's a big stage program in Calcutta, and the Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, has requested the ISKCON devotees to come to that program, and we need 9 more foreign Matajis who will come, and they have to go for the practice either today or tomorrow. So if anyone's interested, and we can contact this Prabhu. So we're asking for 9 more foreign Matajis to go to